Why use pivot tables? Pivot tables allow you to quickly summarize data and, more importantly, quickly change the way data is summarized. Pivot tables cannot be beaten in their ability to do this. Let's look at an example to illustrate this. In this example, we have computer sales data that we would like to have summarized by customer, like this. To get this data into the proper format, we have a couple of options. The first option and the most manual is to add a row above the headers, add a subtotal cell above sales, and manually filter to each customer to record the sales. This would take us all day. Another option that we have is to create a table on a separate tab that contains some if formulas that look up to our main table. This is a valid approach, but what if the request quickly changed to adding brand and product category? This update might take 15 minutes to an hour to complete, but with a pivot table, it's almost instant. Let's look at how. To create a pivot table, select the full range of your data, including headers, go to the Insert tab, select Pivot Table, and then From Table Range. Select OK for the default options, which will create another tab for the pivot table. If you get an error when you try to create a pivot table, the most likely problem is that one of your columns doesn't have a header. Pivot tables will not accept blank headers. Okay, now we've created our pivot table, but what are we looking at? In the pivot table field section, off to the right, you'll see our headers in a scroll list up top, and then a few different options below: filters, columns, rows, and values. If you remember the customer summary table that we're trying to create, it looks like the customer field is in the rows, and the sales field is probably values. Let's try that out. First, we can drag the customer field to the rows section, and then we can drag the sales field to the values section. Cool. The table looks similar to what we wanted to create from the start. Let's quickly update the formatting to match the table we envisioned. To change the formatting, we can either go to Values, Value Field Settings, and Number Format, or we can simply right-click anywhere in the Sales field within the pivot table and select the Number Format. From here, we can choose Currency and show 0 decimal places, then hit OK. Perfect, now we have a table that matches what we initially wanted. But why was this easier or better than the table that was just built with formulas? Here's why. First off, in the scenario that we described earlier where we wanted to quickly look at different views, we can simply swap customer out for different row fields. If we wanted to look at brand, we could remove customer and add brand. We could look at product category, product ID, invoice date, which automatically groups into years, quarters, and months with drill down buttons for each layer. We can make all of these updates within seconds. We can even copy the table and manipulate the table to show different categories as well. Secondly, we can add subcategories below the initial category by dragging another field into the rows section below the first. If we wanted to see a table summarized by customers and then wanted to dig into the brands within each customer, we would add brand under customer. If we wanted to sort the brands below each customer by highest to lowest sales, we can right-click anywhere in the sales field, select sort, and hit largest to smallest. To make this even easier to view, we could drag the brands field to the column section, which allows us to see all of the customers and brands in our viewing window at one time. Lastly, we're able to quickly filter our different table views by dragging fields into the filter section. If we wanted data that was only in the year 2024, we could drag the year field to the filter section, and then we're able to select the dropdown and filter the data to 2024. If we wanted to look at only first generation products, we could add the product category to the filter and select first generation. Pivot tables are extremely versatile and allow you to do analysis a lot faster than manual Excel manipulation or formulas. Test out the concepts that we went through in this video with your next project, and I guarantee you'll be a lot more efficient and effective. Thank you for tuning in, and don't forget to hit the subscribe button.